listeners and viewers, this is me, your host, Fahad Younis, and you are watching Meri Kahani. And as you know, in Meri Kahani show, we've been inviting a lot of wonderful celebrities who come to our show. They share their life stories and inspire a lot of other people who are listening or watching us. So today we also having a very wonderful and special guest live with us from Senegal, and he is Ousmane Bodian live with us. Ousmane is a drummer, and Ousmane, thank you very much for joining us and most welcome in our studios. How are you doing today?
Yeah, I'm fine, brothers. Welcome. I'm fine.
Yeah, thank you very much for joining us, Ousmane. And you know, a lot of people are listening and watching you right now in our show, Meri Kahani. And we'd love to know about, I mean, your life story, how you become like this, and you know, how you started your life and how you become a drummer. Please share this story with our audience.
Okay, thank you very much. First of all, I would like to greet everybody from Senegal, where I'm from, and then up to there in Pakistan, and then everywhere around the world.
Thank you.
To show them that I love all of them, and then let them know that we are all brothers and sisters, you know. Yeah. We always pray for peace. Yeah. I am Ousmane from Senegal. And I used to play drums, I used to play guitar, I used to play hip hop music. Yeah. When I was a little boy, the age of 5 years, my stepfather take me to Gambia to be educated there. So that is why I used to speak English. But Senegal is a French country. Yeah. So I try both of them. I speak both of them. Yeah, I am hereby showing you my talents to let everybody know my story. Yeah, because it's going to bring something, you know, which is better for all of us, because anyone can learn from the other. Yeah. And then from the Gambia, I was there going to school, coming back, and then when my stepfather died, and then I have problem to pay the school fees, so it was not easy. And then I stopped. Year 2000, I go back to Senegal, and then in Senegal I was there with my parents, and I know that the situation is not very, very good, so I must start doing something which, you know, I can earn money and bring to my family. Understand? So by that time, I started going to the workshops from the morning of the afternoon, looking for someone who can teach me. Maybe I go and check for a job which, you know, I can benefit from it, and then my family too. And then I started to work in refrigerators, air conditions. Yeah, I started by that thing. And then when it's the summertime, when it is cold, I can see that job cannot work. It cannot go, because whenever it is cold in Africa, our area, so many people, they off their air conditions, refrigerators. So that is how I enter in music. Because by that time, there is one man who was there, he's a big musician, it's my tribe. And then he was the one who have his band there, and then I started following them because I love music. I used to start, then sometimes I collect their drums, everything they need, I do for them. If they want to drink tea, I cook for them whilst they are playing, and then, you know. So that is how I move, and then I know that I can, when I see that, I can do this thing, so I force myself. Sometimes before they start, I take the little drums and then start playing. And then when the man shows me, he told me that you can be a good artist if you learn. I tell him, yes, I want to learn. He tell me, okay, then now, no problem. I will try and teach you little by bit by bit. So that is how I enter in music. I started going from the littles of the big one, the big drum, the bass. And then from that, I enter the four drums, which is known as bougarabou. And that bougarabou, you can find it in Senegal, but the where it comes from is kasamas. It is four drums. With only one person play it. So that is how I move on it. And then I start also learning about to play guitar. And then I check for another one who can play the drums for me. And then I create my own group. When I created my own group, I was the one who was playing the guitar. I have four or five girls inside the group. And then for the boys, we were eight in the number. So every time, Saturday, Sunday, we go and play to the ceremonies, this thing, how to call it, birthdays, and then so many things which, you know, we have to perform there. Sometimes we go to for carnival, and then still now I'm looking for my chance. Yeah, still now I'm learning still now.
All right, wonderful. Yeah, of course, you have a lovely and special life story, I can say. I mean, you've been, you know, traveling all around the areas, and you learn a lot from your life. So, Ousmanian, you know, a lot of youngsters are watching you. Would you love to please share more about, you know, this drumming thing? And I mean, what is the use of that thing in your area? And, you know, what is the best this thing in your area? Can you please share with us?
We just play as how we like to play. But sometimes, because that drum, which is known as Bugarabu, is a cultural thing. It is a cultural thing from our village, Kasamas. So there are some kind of, you know, rhythms which, you know, if you play it, even the old ladies or the old mans, which, you know, that they cannot move, they will try and then dance, because you have touched them at a point. Do you understand? So that was the secret of the drums. As how I can play, everybody can play. But sometimes we used to play, and then whenever you play, somebody sitting and then listening to you or watching you dancing, maybe he can take a little, you know, in that sound, it can remind him something, him or her, it can remind him something. Because these drums we created, our grandfathers created whenever they want to make a meeting. So these are the drums where they remove outside and then start playing it, pom 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 pom, and then all the peoples will hear, and then you will see people will try and come back. People will come, and then you closer to them, and then they try and send their message to everybody. Tell them what is their message, and then after started the program, which is just to be dancing. Everybody feel free and then happy. Yeah.
Great.
That's how we do it.
So, how people can see your work? I mean, if they wanna check your videos and, you know, you playing the drums, so how they can reach you? Or do you have a specific URL or link? So please share with the audience so people can find you, and maybe share your Facebook URL so people can be your friends, you know, and then in Pakistan. So please share if you have any resources and links.
Okay, the I did not open another link. I have only just opened that one page in my Facebook. If you enter in my Facebook, you will see the page down. But that one, I think, is only two videos there. But inside my Facebook, I have downloaded there. I have saved it there, two videos, which I have seen for Rehan Alwara, and then the other one is the drums, and then the other one is the guitar. Yeah, but okay. For anyone who want to see my things, you can enter in Jamoral for Life. After I will give you the spellings, and then you can give it to
everybody. Sure. All right, wonderful. So, brother, you know, you are in a different, you know, a country, and with a different culture, and, you know, with a different language. So a lot of people are listening and watching you over there. Would you love to share a bit about your country, about the people over there, about the cultures over there, so people can, you know, learn about your country and the culture?
Yeah, you are welcome, brother. That is not a problem. Sure. Yeah, Senegal, we say Alhamdulillah. Yeah, because we are all one. We are all one. The peoples, they love each other, and then each compound, anyone can enter in any compound you want. There is no border between us. So in Senegal, we used to share ideas, good ideas, and then even if you see a little boy who is not doing something good, you can even cut the hand, and then you take him onto his house, and then tell them he's doing so, and then they will try and stop him, you know. And then by the side of the Muslims and the Christians also, we are all one. There's no difference between all of us, as we are all human beings. That is a very, very nice thing, which, you know, it makes me happy, because whenever people are joined to be one, they make peace. That is why I'm so proud of that. Yeah. And then Senegal, we have so many kind of cultures there. For me, my tribe, I am a Jola. In Jola, in our cultural things, you can find so many, many, many things, which, you know, you can find it inside our tribe. And then we have Wolof also. Wolof is the most popularity in Senegal. That is the next language. Apart from French, it is the first language, which is Wolof. We have Mandinkas. And then Mandinkas also are from our area, Casamance. We have Balanta, we have Manjaku, Manoj, we have Papel, everything, you know. We have a lot of people's names. But they are all very good. They are all good. They love peace and then, you know, they love each other.
Awesome. How about the weather over there, and, you know, how about the agriculture? I mean, what people, you know, do in routine in your country?
Yeah, in our country, first of all, I will start it from my own village. In my own village, what we use for our agriculture is that the farmers, we used to grow this thing, how to call it, groundnut, rice. That is the most powerful thing. That is the most powerful. Because our area, we are just near to the beach side, the river side. So that is the place where we used to grow rice. And then the groundnut, we don't grow it by the beach side. It's another side. Uh-huh. And then sometimes we grow maize, you know. And then how to call it, kiddos. This thing for Ambaba. Corn. We used to grow corn also, you know. Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh. We used to grow all those things there, yeah. And then in our area also, we have the palm trees, which, you know, the women, our mothers used to go and then take the seeds of the palm, and then they come and change it to the palm oil. Yeah, they do it by the palm, they change it to make it palm oil. Whenever they need to do that kind of things, they used to call many, many peoples, I can say all the village will come and join. They will be singing, dancing, and then some also will be doing their jobs to get the palm oil. Yeah, that is how they do for our culture.
Wonderful. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much. So, brother, you know, a lot of youngsters are watching you right now. Do you have any special message for our viewers, if you want to share, please?
For the young youths today.
Yeah, and especially about your field, if they want to come to this field, I mean, what would you suggest them?
Yes, you know, first of all, I would like to say, I know it will not be easy for everybody to live like that, but we should all try, we the young men, the young ladies. We are the future of tomorrow. We are the ones who should be, how to call it, we are the ones who should be intelligent. And then the intelligent, you cannot create peace without intelligent. No. You must be intelligent. And then you must be someone who used to forgive. No matter how it is. Because Allah, God, is the one who created us. But He used to forgive. If you have that thing in your heart, forgiveness, I think there will be no more problem. For me, I think there will be no more problem. So for we, the youths of today, let us please forgive each other and then forget the bad things which have passed. Because if you don't forget the past thing which have passed, you will never forgive. And then we the youths are the ones who should fight and bring peace. There was one of my posts. I say, if we want, we can be brothers and sisters. As we our brothers and sisters in our families, the same blood. That can be, maybe some people will say, how can that be? It can be. You just love the one you see, like how you love yourself. Never hurt him, Because you know that if he hurts you, it will be something which, you know, it can make you angry, and then you will do something. That is the most important point for me, my style. Me, I can say I have no enemy. Yeah, me, I can say that. I have no enemy because my heart is clean for everybody. So we try and maintain those things. Even if you see someone who is entering something which, you know, is not good. Even in our life today, we are in a hurry to get money. But before we get money, we have to be silent and know how to go with it.
All right. So, brother, you know, at the end, we have a final question for our, you know, guests who come to our show in Meri Kahani. Would you love to say anything about this initiative, Meri Kahani, or maybe you want to suggest something to our show?
Yes, just like as how I see it right now, this is a show which is very important. Very important. Like for me, I never know you guys. And then you also never know me, but we know each other in Facebook. But to know about my country, you must contact me. For me also to know about your country, I must contact you. And only God knows when, you know, maybe you will come to my country or me, I will come to your country. So before coming, you already know about the country and then you know how to do. Understand? So it is a very important, so which you know that people can learn so many different things from different countries. Yeah, it's very important.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, brother, for joining us, and we'll be connected in future as well. Once again, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much.
Take care.
Love you all. Take care.
Love you too. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye. All right, so this was our today's show. As you hear the story of Ousmane Bodian, he was live with us from Senegal. He shared with us, and you can also share your life stories with us, and our page is www.facebook.com/Meri Kahani, and our website is www.merikahani.org. This is me, Fahad Younis, and the show is Meri Kahani. This is all from today. See you in next week. Take care. Bye-bye.